jubilated.
The collector of the district, the members of the trust, the correspondent, headmaster, and the members of the teaching faculty, ladies and gentlemen, and dear students. I'm extremely happy to associate myself with the Silver Jubilee function of the MGR school this evening. I must congratulate the trust as well as the member of the faculty for their splendid accomplishment. I'm listening to the report with considerable interest. The president of the trust has been taking considerable pains to raise the funds and construct the buildings by organizing various functions at the district headquarters. Of course, the beginning was laid by our Honorable Dr. MGR, who donated the land and who has been the moving force and has provided the inspiration for the MGR schools. Starting on with only 26 students 25 years back, it has grown into an institution which has now more than 6,000 students. It's a splendid achievement. It has risen from state to state, from the primary to the middle and then to the higher secondary level. And considerable efforts have gone into it. I also find that the results from year to year have been excellent, and I'm told for the last 3 years it has been 100%. That again is a matter of great satisfaction and rejoicing. I must congratulate all those who won the awards today because of their excellent performance in studies and other activities. The school which has been named after our Honorable Chief Minister, and the trust which is named after his respected mother, reflects the ideals for which MGR has always advocated, and his ideals about the education. In 1959, he thought in terms of providing education, providing facilities to the students. And as the motto which was then brought out, knowledge is power, shows the depth which is behind the activities which have to be taken up by the students. If you look at our education, these ideas were spread out by your Honorable Prime Minister, discussed in work has been done, and yet we have a long way to go if we think in terms of what literacy means and what education means to our country. We have in the Constitution that we mentioned there that we must have free education, elementary education, provided between the ages of 6 to 11. We have made tremendous progress there. For the boys have already reached 100%. I even figured more than that. The girls have figured about 78 to 80%. But then we are worried. One is, of course, as far as the girls are concerned, we must accomplish that figure of 100%. But our matter of greater concern is the dropouts, because the number of dropouts happens to be quite large. And unless all of them complete their education, our efforts do not bear the full fruit that we want them to. When we come to the middle standards, in the middle standards again, we find as far as the boys are concerned, we accomplish the figure of 78%. For the girls, the figure remains to be 50%. And for the higher secondary schools, the figure for the boys is 50%, and the girls come to about 32%. If we look at the literacy percentage and the figures, though we are doing better than many other states, yet our figure has still lagging behind. And again, the figure of 36%, which may be for the entire country, we have made greater progress than the rest of the country, but yet we have a long way to go. Education
is derived from the Latin word which means educare. Educare means taking out. Taking out means the developing the faculties of the students. For education we mean that we must have the mental horizons widened. They must be able to have the people understand both the physically and intellectually there must be development of the person. Tiruvallur mentioned about education and said it's the functioning eye and the rest are blind unless the education is there. Again, in Tamil, there's a poem which says that it's education. Everything else, neither the floods, nor the famine, nor the fire can destroy education. It's in the minds and it's in the memories of the people. That's the education which can lead the persons to the highest standard of living, which can lead the person to acquire that knowledge. And these days it's becoming all the more important. Because learning and the education as it is imparted today has to undergo a change because we find that every day as the knowledge expands, it becomes out of date, particularly in the scientific field. Whether it's a scientific field, it's a medical field, it's an engineering field. What is being taught today might be found to have grown out of date with the developments as we find in the bioengineering, biotechnology, and in the engineering field and the biochemistry development as it has been taking place. So it becomes necessary therefore that as the children and the school boys and the girls are taught, it should not only be a matter of teaching, but they should be able to learn. They should develop the habit of reading, that they should be able on their own to further augment the knowledge which they derive in the classrooms and otherwise, because absolutely essential these days that we keep up to date with what is happening, and that can only be done by inculcating the habit of reading, by learning, by having that kind of change which is happening. Again, we are finding a large number of changes are taking place in the method of teaching. We have now the audiovisual aids which are coming more and more to the assistance of the teachers. We have got the computer education which is, and everything, every one of these steps has to be carefully considered at what stage these can be introduced, what can be done so that the students can derive the fullest benefit that they can from the education. Education doesn't mean that we have to learn only our whatever is given in our textbooks. We have to, because we are wedded to certain philosophy and certain ideas, and these ideas must be propagated. It's Anna who mentioned that it is duty, discipline and dignity which must form the core, and these are the guidelines. And these guidelines must be dinned into the students, that the students develop all these three traits while they are studying in the educational institution. Dr. MGR, who has been the spirit behind this, has also through his life and the manner in which he has lived, the manner he has played his role either in the cinema or outside in this political field, he has stood and cherished certain values. It's today very important that our educational system place considerable emphasis upon the moral values, as these moral values which would be able ultimately to raise the individual to a particular standard. As regards the moral values, it is from, right from Mahatma Gandhi, we hear from Dr. Radhakrishnan, we have Anna, we have everybody talking about the moral values which must be inculcated in the students. And Dr. Radhakrishnan mentioned about it, a nation is built in our educational institutions. Moral values are far more important than the intellectual attainments. And Gandhiji mentioned, true education is that education which leads to the molding of the right type of character. And it's on this that the emphasis has got to be placed in our school and our college education. Then we find that we stand the national integration today, one hears about the late Prime Minister mentioned about it. The present Prime Minister misses no opportunity of stressing what should be done and what the educated and what the country needs is the national integration. This kind of a spirit must be inculcated amongst our boys and girls. All the students these days are those who have been born in free India. They have not witnessed, they have not seen what the sacrifices have been which have gone into winning over the freedom, but they are having the fruits of the freedom. It is essential that we are in a position to maintain it. This can be maintained only if they are made aware of the sacrifices made therein, how the freedom was won, how the freedom has got to be retained. We have given ourselves a constitution. We say we are a democratic, secular, socialist republic. Now what democracy means, what secularism means, this is again to be brought home to the students and what effort should be made by them. In the curriculum must be included certain books, a certain text which give an idea about the freedom movement, about our great leaders. The leaders may be in the political field, may be in the scientific field, may be in the literary world, and these leaders about which they must know, because they are the ones who can inspire the generation. Then we have a cultural heritage. What our cultural heritage is, how it has come to be built up, how it has to be maintained. Because ours is a vast country, there is unity, and behind there is also diversity, diversity in the culture, but we can never lose sight of the unity that permeates behind all. All these ideas have to be inculcated in the minds of students. Apart from learning the textbooks, whatever is contained and passing the examinations, it becomes essential that our educational system, and particularly the books which are prescribed, cater to these particular needs. And now that we have got the Prime Minister, he has set up a committee which will go into the educational policy, which will lay down an educational policy for the country, starting on the higher education. But what is to be done in the higher education ultimately comes out from what should learn at the lower levels. And I think this school, these institutions which are named after our Chief Minister, would imbibe, would try to see that all these things, they don't lag behind and they are in a position to go ahead with it. Another suggestion I'd like to make in this connection would be, the school has reached a higher secondary standard. Would like now the vocational stream to be introduced, because that's the policy of the state government, and we want that those boys and girls coming out of it should be able to find employment for themselves, should be able to find the avenues for themselves, and the vocational stream at the right time can be introduced therein, depending upon the availability of the teachers and the material that is there. With these words, I offer my heartiest congratulations to the Board of Trustees, to its president, who has been straining every possible nerve to keep these institutions going and making his contribution towards it, and to all the members of the faculty and the staff who have been trying to see that their boys and girls who are placed under their charge achieve the best possible results. Thank you.
Mrs. Lada Rajendran, the principal of the Janaki Ramachandran Kalalaya Matriculation Higher Secondary School, will propose vote of thanks.
On behalf of Satya Educational and Charitable Society and on behalf of the Silver Jubilee Committee, we tender our heartfelt thanks to His Excellency Thiru S. L. Kurana, the Governor of Tamil Nadu, who has graciously consented to be the chief guest and deliver the Silver Jubilee Address. Our heartfelt thanks are also to our Honorable Minister for Finance and Revenue, Thiru Nedunjerian, for having released the souvenir, and to Thiru Aranganaigam, Honorable Minister for Education, who has distributed the prizes to the teachers and students. We also thank Mr. K. Rajaram, former Honorable Speaker of Legislative Assembly of Tamil Nadu and President of Satya Educational and Charitable Society, for having kindly accepted our invitation to preside over the celebrations. We also thank the Director of Government Examinations, Collector of Madras, the Chief Educational Officer, District Educational Officers, Deputy Inspector of Schools, and also the headmasters and headmistresses, teachers, parents, members of the Silver Jubilee Committee, and others present here. We also thank all those who donated for the souvenir, the press, information and broadcasting department, TV technicians, and members of the Scouts and Guides. We also thank the All India Radio. We once again thank one and all. Thank you.
The students of MGR schools will present a cultural program immediately after the national anthem. I request all the ladies and gentlemen to remain here. Now the national anthem.
Yeah. இந்த இடத்தை நீங்கள் எப்படியாவது வைத்துக் கொண்டு வர வேண்டும்.
உன்னை என் தேவியாக